The old man just kicked me out of the car.
He's gonna steal
He's
your
taking
car.
My car. Hey, I get that old man. What the? I just got robbed by an old man.
How did this happen to me?
What is going on, guys? Welcome back to GTA 5 Roleplay, or RP, here on the channel. Now, today, we're gonna be doing something you guys have been begging me to do, and that is GTA 5 RP as an undercover police officer. Now, last episode, we were doing the chain gang stuff, but now we are undercover and about to take over the city. Well, not take over, but lay the law down. Let people know that we're here. Jobless Garrett's here, and I'm here to do some great things. If you guys do enjoy the episode, make sure you guys drop a like. Let's go for over 15,000 likes. I don't think it's possible, to be honest. Every episode gets 100,000 views. 15,000 likes, that's a lot of likes. I don't know. If we could do it, that'd be awesome, but maybe you guys should prove me wrong. Let me know if you guys do it. If you guys do hit that goal, you know what? I'll make you guys a deal. If we hit 15,000 likes, I'll do a weekend of straight RP every day. So show that love, 15,000 likes. So that car right there is a general police officer car, right? And I'm an undercover police officer. So check this out, dude. You guys ready for this? Boom, boys! Check out my sexy whip. Now, let me tell you, this thing is fast, it's secretive, and gets the job done. So without further ado, what? There's a monkey on a bike. I don't even know. Let's patrol the city. So while we're patrolling, we want to find people that run red lights. We want to find people that go ahead and steal cars. Of course, we're going to go ahead and go to Los Santos Customs. I want to upgrade the car to have like no front bumper thing and like maybe a few customizations that you wouldn't normally have on a police vehicle. And I want to quickly point out how freaking cool it is. This car has my name on the back. Just want to say that. That's pretty cool. And this monkey is just riding all up. Okay, we're going to pull this monkey over. Listen, monkey. You can't be riding your bicycle in the middle of the road. This isn't a circus, all right?
All right, man, I'm sorry. Animal control's after me, you know, so I'm on edge.
Well, keep your freaking bicycle on the sidewalk, or we're gonna have to go ahead and impound your bike, all right there, Mr. Monkey Man?
All right.
You have a great night. I swear, these monkeys in these cities, they're a bunch of crazy people. A bunch of crazies, I tell you. And like that, dudes. Look at that. That's sexy, dudes. Look at that bad boy. You can't even tell them a police car. They have no idea what's coming, dudes. So I just got a call that a robbery is taking place on Elgin Ave. And I have no freaking clue where that is. So I managed to find Elgin Ave, but I have no idea where this person is that's a hostage, unless they're over here. So these guys behind me are following me, it seems like, and they just smashed into the back of my cruiser. I've gone ahead and requested additional units, so...
Excuse me, officer.
Yeah, don't worry, I'm here, sorry. I fell asleep at the wheel for a second there.
Can I have a word?
Yep, sure, one second. So this black SUV seems like he's following us. I don't know what's going on. Sir, can you please step back into your vehicle? I don't know what's going on here. I don't even know why you stopped, sir. Please keep driving. This guy in the black SUV is gonna get arrested.
I stopped because he was following me. He was behind me, bro. So I came behind you and asked what's your problem.
Hey, calm down. Whoa.
This guy is lying, man. This man's right here. Yeah, he's lying.
Hold on. We're gonna get to the bottom of this. I need to know, what is your name?
My name's Kay.
Let me see your ID, sir. I don't know what's going on. This is so weird. And there's also no freaking cops coming to help me. I feel like I'm the only cop in this whole goddamn city. Let's step onto the sidewalk. All right, Kay, you seem that you have insurance. You have no criminal history, which is good to hear. All righty. And can I see your ID, sir? Perfect. Neither of you guys have criminal history, so that's good to hear. My name's Officer Gary Berry. I don't know exactly what's going on. I'm trying to get the full story here. So if you guys don't mind, I would like to go ahead and just search both of you to see what exactly is going on. I'm very confused on, you know, one person asking for help, the other person asking for help. So let's just see what's going on. So do either of you guys have any weapons on you that you'd be worried about?
Nope.
Yeah, I do.
As long as you have a firearms permit like this gentleman in front of me, you should be fine. Kane, I'm gonna go and search you now. And everything should check out. Now, unfortunately for Kane, he has 20 grams of cannabis on him. That's not good. Perfect. You have a firearm permit on you. I see you have a driver's license and a cell phone, so you're good to go. And are both these cars belong to you guys?
Yes.
Awesome. Okay, simple. Well, look, I don't know what the confusion was here and what you guys had problems with. And if you guys are following one another, you guys need to, you know, stop that. But that's going to come to an end now. So unfortunately, Kane, for you, I'm going to have to go ahead and arrest you. Unfortunately for you, sir, you have 20 grams of cannabis on you, which is a very illegal amount of marijuana. Way more than you're supposed to have.
Oh, shit.
Sir, with the yellow truck. I'm gonna ask you to go ahead and leave the scene. Kane, let's talk about this, man. Why do you have so much marijuana on you? Are you dealing? Have you fallen on hard times, Kane? What's going on?
Nah, I just like to get high, man.
So this is what I'm gonna do, Kane. I am gonna go ahead and place you under arrest.
Yeah.
I have an additional unit here to help me with this, with the scene of the crime, it seems like. If you can just go ahead and walk with me to my cruiser, we can go ahead and get you in the back, and I'll take you to the police station here. Hello, officer.
What's he being charged with, officer?
Well, you see, this yellow truck here had asked me to go ahead and pull over. He wanted to speak to me, and then this guy stopped. And this gentleman went ahead and oh so nicely crashed his car into the back of my car, conversing with the two individuals and asking if I had their consent to search them. It seems that this man right here named Kane has an illegal substance on him of large amounts. So, alrighty, Kane, I really hope, Kane, for your sake, man, this car is yours. Last chance to tell the truth. Is that your vehicle?
No, that's not my vehicle, man.
Oh, Kane. Oh, Kane. Come on, man.
I think that's the first little tidbit of truth you've told all day.
What's weird about it, Kane, is you didn't even have to stop. I don't even know why you stopped your car to talk to me.
I know.
I'm going to take you to the police station, and thank you, officer, for coming over.
Oh, no worries. No worries. I heard your radio call. Sorry, it took me.
Alrighty, Kane. We're going to put you inside my cruiser.
Yeah.
Kane. You made such a mistake, man. You could have easily just gotten away from the whole situation, but instead, you wanted to have a large amount of marijuana on you, and... Oh, man, you messed up.
I didn't even know, man. I completely forgot about the car.
Kane. Now, listen, we could talk about this, all right? You don't have a large rap sheet behind you. You're not a criminal, it seems like. You know, it seemed like you're just wrong place, wrong time, accidentally stole someone's vehicle, and you just happen to have a large amount of marijuana on you. Mistakes happen, man. It happens all the time. You know, I might let you off easier than a normal requirement that I'm supposed to lay on you, but we'll see what happens, all right?
All right, man, I appreciate it.
Just comply and, you know, I might let you off easy. You can't, like, you know, rush these things, so we'll see what happens when we get into the station, and if there's no sergeant here, then you might get lucky. So I'm probably gonna let this guy off pretty easily, guys. Like, clearly did not know, and I've been in his shoes. I've been in this guy's shoes where, like, you have a large amount of marijuana on you on accident, you didn't know you had it, right? Not in real life, like... in the RP series, and it happens, you know, sometimes you just forget you have it on you. It is what it is. So this is what I'm gonna do. You know, I'm gonna look into what the requirement of time is for me to go ahead and jail him, and from there we're gonna decide how long we're actually gonna give him. Poor guy, dudes. Poor guy. Like, I feel bad for him, you know, like, let's see how long he is supposed to get. Alrighty, Kane, according to my paper right here, I'm supposed to give you over 20 months in jail. Now, that's a long time, man. 20 months for a little bit of marijuana and, you know, accidentally getting into a car that may have been your friend's that was no longer with you. I don't know the whole story. This is what I'm gonna do for you, Kane. I'm gonna give you some jail time, but it's only gonna be 8 months. Really cutting you some slack here, man. That's a pretty good deal. You were super cooperative. You had weapons on you that you could have, you know, done some damage with, but you didn't. So I appreciate that. I'm gonna write up your paperwork now, and I'll see you when you get out, I guess, man. Best of luck. Kane has been sent off for 8 months for having marijuana, and, you know, I'm not supposed to see it, but he also had an AK-47 on him, which is very illegal. And I gotta find out more information about that because I don't know how it works when you have the little Draco AK on your person. So I gotta find out from fellow officers how that works. So there's a guy apparently super suicidal right now that's jumping off bridges, and I don't know. Oh god, I think he just died.
Oh my god, he jumped.
31's location.
He jumped.
Dude, I guess he didn't want to go to jail, man. What was he even being stopped for?
He had a bat and he was trying to crush police vehicles at PD, and I ran all the way from PD to here with him.
Oh my god. Let's find his body real quick. I know EMS is on the way. Are you still with us, sir? Well, it sounds like he's still alive. EMS is on their way. Sir, stay with us. He is bleeding out. That was a very high jump. Guys, I don't know if this guy's gonna make it. There's a guy over here, like, drinking water from the sewers. I'm gonna grab my medkit. Apparently, this guy is still alive somehow. I don't even know. I'm gonna grab a medkit from my back of my cruiser real quick and pick this guy up. All right, hold on. Stay with me, man. Stay with me. You're gonna be all right. You're just bleeding from every hole possible. But luckily enough for you, I got a lot of bandages. I'm gonna put a big one in your butthole. The bleeding has stopped. Holy, what a lifesaver I am. All right, help me lift this guy up. Help me lift him up. All right, count it down when you're ready.
3, 2, 1.
All right, here we go. Oh, there you go.
Oh, it's magic.
Ho, 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 it's magic.
Oh. Perfect. Now you're going to jail.
Yeah, come back here.
So far, patrolling the city hasn't been too bad. We've had one suicidal guy. We've had one guy have drugs on him. What's next? Like, I feel like every time I go on duty in the city, there's something really weird happening. I enjoy being a cop, and I think you guys like watching me be a cop as well. So if you guys do, make sure you guys drop a like, because it's been a great episode thus far, and hopefully we can continue some great things. And what is happening here? What the hell is happening there? What is... The bank alarm just went, oh my God! The bank alarm just went off. So we going up there right now. It's about to be a full force. There's like six officers on duty now. I don't know where these mother truckers were at when I freaking called for them earlier, but it's about to go down, boys. It's about to go down like downtown. I'm really hoping they got hostages, and I hope they have a lot of guns, because I want to kill some people. Arrest some people. An officer of the law never wants to commit murder. I'm gonna take this door right here. It's about to be crazy, boys. I'm gonna grab my AR from the trunk. Bam! I grab my AR. It's looking sexy, dudes. Come out with your hands up! All right, dudes. It's about to get intense!
Los Santos Police Department!
I'm just an old man.
There's an old man in the back of the bank. We got an old man! Old man robbing the bank! Let's go, old man yeller! What's going on here?
So what's going on, man?
I just want to get to my bike. Just let me get to my bike.
Oh, dudes, it's Bert.
All right, give us a hostage and we'll make that happen.
Oh, he knows that's not gonna be true. This is not gonna work.
Come on out.
We got an old man hostage and we got Bert. Oh God.
All right, put your hands up. You're surrounded now.
He's tased. They deployed the taser. What the? How could they? Oh my God. I just want to tase him. Oh yes. Oh yes. Bert's going to jail. Yes. We did it. Oh my, that was intense. Let's go ahead and search him real quick. Search this guy. He should have known better, dudes. Bert should have known better. We freaking stopped the bank robbery. Bert. What are we going to do with you? It feels like every day you're just getting in trouble, man. Don't you learn your lesson?
Oh shit.
Jesus. Oh. Totally. Sorry.
No, that. I deserve that. I agree, sir.
I don't even know how my character just punched him. Bam! Freaking Mayweathered him there for a second. I want to question this old man and see how he even got involved with this Bert individual. Come with me, old man. So how did you become a hostage of the one and only Bert, man? What happened here?
Oh, I was trying to make a deposit, man. It's crazy.
This guy sounds like he's about to croak over and die right now.
And I didn't know what to do. Listen,
sir, are you having an asthma attack over there? Are you okay? Do you need paramedics? Are you all right? Don't die on me.
Give me a punch. Get a kick back up. Give me a punch.
All right, I got you. There we go. Oh my God, this guy's dying on us, dude. What is happening? I'm not trained for all this. All right, do you need paramedics to assist you with anything? How are you feeling? How are you...
I mean, he took all my money. If you can give me a taxi cab home, that'd be great.
Sure. Where's home?
Close to the police station.
I'll just jump in my cruiser. Come on.
Sick ride.
So I'm gonna give this old man a ride, and I don't know. Like I don't even know how he got so.
I was gonna make it out of there alive, man.
Yeah, I mean, you were messing with the wrong type of dude, man. But lucky enough for you, there's a ton of officers on duty today or tonight, I should say. Where did you say you live again?
Take a left.
Hey. Officers, yeah, can you guys not crash into one? Sir? Geez. It's okay.
You listen here, sonny. You learn how to drive right now. I'll beat your ass.
God. You guys want to get that guy in right there? Oh! Whoa! The old man just kicked me out of the car. Hey.
Be okay.
What did you push me out of the car for, sir? The old man just pushed me out of the car.
He's gonna steal
He's
your
taking
car.
My car! Hey! Hey, get that old man! What the? I just got robbed by an old man! How does this happen to me? How does this happen to me? What the dicks? Sometimes I think that this police work just isn't for me. But listen, if you guys are enjoying this series, make sure you guys show that love. 15,000 likes is what I said at the beginning. I want to thank you guys so much for all the most recent support and everything we've been doing, because it's been a lot of fun. Hopefully you guys have been enjoying every step of the way. And without further ado, I'm going to talk to you guys tomorrow with a brand new video. Bye, guys.